First topic for the session, cover the various sources of working capital requirements. Now we know working capital requirements are very important. It should not be excess, it should not be inadequate as well. But what are the various sources an organization can tap for various working capital requirements? The sources can be long term or short term again. In long term, we focus on the same shares, debentures, retained earnings, loans from financial institutions or public deposits. Shares which we have covered before, the concepts remain the same. A shareholder, equity shareholders or preference shareholders, the concept remain the same. Equity shareholder becomes the owner of the company. He takes part in decision making and he is actually bound to the ultimate risk and being the ownership in him. Preference shareholders get a fixed rate of preference dividend and they do not have any voting rights. They get preferential treatment, as the name says, in terms of payment of dividend. Similarly, at the time of binding of the company as well, they are paid before equity shareholders. Debenture holders are like a loan holders of a company, and a company can take a loan from the public. And take a loan from a company, it is called as a debenture. Similarly, a company can take a loan from a financial institution as well. The various sources of long-term finance. Similarly, a company can use its retained earnings. These we have covered before in various sources in deep. And the same sources a company can tap here also in working capital requirements. Or the company can go for a short-term sources as well. The company can take as a short-term loans. Company can go for short-term arrangements with the suppliers or lenders. Like, for example, deciding on the credit period or giving them advance as such. Any arrangements with the buyer or a seller. It's just as to their relationships with the other party. Or the company can go for short-term instruments. That is, short-term instruments are trading the money market. A company can go for various and tap the sources for them, like commercial paper, discounting of bills. The company can tap them, or the company can go for installment credit. What is installment? Comes same like hire purchase. You purchase a asset and you can pay them in equal installments over a period of time. Or the company can go for bank loan. So the various ways you can see a company can go for long term and short term point of view. Now you must be wondering, which source should a company tap? Should we tap long term sources or should we tap short term sources? The next topic we'll be seeing is what the various sources a company should actually tap for raising its working capital.